What's going on YouTube? So today's video, let's dive into the brand of Bond Number 9. So whenever I do these Bond reviews, I guess these videos are pretty much for myself. I personally do like the brand. The prices, on the other hand, can be a little expensive. But today we're gonna be talking about a very forgotten fragrance from the Bond of Bond Number 9, and that is gonna be New York Musk, which was launched in 2012 and is classed as a woody floral musk. The note breakdown, according to Fragrantica, is gonna be blackcurrant along with grapefruit blossom. In the mid is gonna be green lily, osmanthus, and nutmeg. And the base is musk, sandalwood, patchouli, and vetiver. So what do I get out of this scent here? I've worn this quite a bit and I'm almost done this decant. In the opening, I get lots of blackcurrant. And this blackcurrant is actually quite nice. It gives it some depth and it also gives it a lot of fruitiness. Then the musk really does come into play. So the musk is the most prominent note to this scent, along with that sandalwood. The sandalwood does come in a little bit longer, a little bit later, I should say. But the musk, it does come into play, and that blackcurrant does retain. This musk is very inoffensive. It's not animalistic, it's not BO. It's a nice, clean musk. I find with the musk, it does kind of man this fragrance up, and this is considered a unisex fragrance. Well, I find that this really does lean more so towards the masculinity. But what kind of gives it that unisex feel is that blackcurrant. The blackcurrant kind of like softens it up a little bit and kind of gives it a little bit of a gentility, if you will. And then that's when the sandalwood does come into play during the dry down, along with a little bit of a dank patchouli. What makes this fragrance a little bit different on my skin, and it's not in the note breakdown itself, but I get a little bit of an oudy, rosy take. There's a little bit of a smokiness from this scent. So I'm assuming that it's gonna be from the sandalwood, but I do get a slight oudy, rosy feel from this fragrance. And I'm not into rosy or oudy scents, yet this is a fragrance that I truly do appreciate and love. When I first smelled this fragrance, I was really keen set on some of the notes. I thought that this was not gonna work for me, that I know for a fact that I'm not gonna like this one. But I really do enjoy this one. So you have to kind of give it a few wearings in order to really truly appreciate it, but also for it to change your mind. So when to wear this one seasons wise. This would be a great fall, but also spring scent. I think that with the musk, it makes it more of a fall type of scent along with that sandalwood. But in the springtime, I think that the blackcurrant and the musk as well kind of would do well in the spring setting. When to wear it occasion wise? Well, this is a very versatile fragrance. You could dress this one down to something that's fashionable, nothing too casual, like too sloppy, too bummy, but you know, something with a little, like with a nice button up or something like this, with a nice pair of jeans or khakis, something like that, to a tuxedo event. You could wear this to work, to a nice little casual outing, to a nice dinner. This is not really a school scent. I don't really picture seeing a student of any kind, unless they're a mature student in college, because I don't really see this working for like someone who's in their early 20s going to school. I'm sorry, I just don't. I find that this just does have that a little bit of a mature feel, but it's not like old man or old woman mature. It just has that feeling that someone with experience and with age would really truly appreciate this one. Longevity was really good off this. I got 7 to 9 hours, and projection was more so on the moderate side. After a few hours, after like hour 2, 3, and even 4, I could still smell whiffs and wafts of this one whenever the wind would hit me. And I would still get remnants of that scent. I wouldn't even have to do this. I would actually just smell it off my skin, just with like the wind breezing. So with a bottle, I could see this being very heavy. Prices for this, well, on the official website, I believe this goes anywhere from $300 to $400 USD. I think it's around the $350 mark, which is quite expensive. Yet I've seen a 50 ml on FragranceNet for under $100. To be specific, $97 USD for a 50 ml. So that's $127 between 127 and 130 Canadian. And for a 100 ml, I think it was going for about a $125 to $135 USD. That is tremendous value for what you're getting. So wife's thoughts on this one. Wife enjoys this one. She likes it, and I was quite surprised because I thought that she was gonna pick up on the rosy oudiness and that smokiness, which she does not get. She gets the blackcurrant, she gets the musk, of course, and she also gets plenty of sandalwood, and she does like it. She finds it leans a little bit more so on the masculine side as well as myself. So final thoughts of Bond number 9's New York Musk. This is a fragrance that really does need to get looked into, especially if you're a Bond number 9 fanboy or fangirl. I can understand why this one really has not been reviewed or really has been forgotten from people, because Bond number 9 just pumps fragrance after fragrance out, kind of like how I do with videos. But this is a fragrance that I know will get lost in the shuffle with the over amount of Bond number 9 fragrances. I personally love it. I love how it smells, and I'm not into overly musky scents. The only other musky fragrance that really does come to mind is Ferragamo Black Musk Atomo, or Ferragamo Atomo Black Musk. Yet this is done better. It's better blended, better ingredients. So yes, you are gonna smell the difference in quality. Yet this is a scent that you need to look into. I find that it's a great bang for your buck value if you get it on the online discounters. However, if you are scared of getting a fake or a dupe or just a bootleg copy, then you're gonna have to go to the official Bond store itself. But I'm all about that money in my pocket. And if I were to get this online, I would get other fragrances from the brand as well. I love how it's versatile. The smell itself is unique enough that it does stand out. Musk, blackcurrant, patchouli, and the patchouli is not overly dominant as well, and sandalwood. This is a masculine scent, even though that it is marketed as unisex. But if you're a woman who wants to wear it, by all means, please try this one out for yourself. My rating out of 5, this is gonna have to be a 4 3/4 out of 5. I think what would make this one a complete masterpiece is that if the price tag itself, when it comes to retail price, was a little bit lower. Bond number 9 does have very expensive retail price, and I think that's one of the flaws, or that's what gets the brand a lot of criticism, is that like you are paying quite a bit. Yet I think that this fragrance, if you were to shop around and get the best deal, I think it's money well spent. I just might get a bottle myself. Don't need a large bottle, but I think that a 50 ml would sit nicely in my collection. And this is a man that's actually trimmed down his collection quite a bit. I think I got rid of 40 fragrances, and I'm already working on a haul video. So everyone, that is my review of Bond number 9's New York Musk. Any other reviews that I've done from this brand, they will be in the description below. If you wanna check out other great niche fragrances, then check out this list here of Atkinson's. And if you wanna check out some seasonal list of niche, then please check out this side here. Guys, I thank you for your time, take care, and I'll see you later. Thanks for watching, everybody.